Tazadaq, the Greek man, Stephen Creditor, Star Seed, the Howard's Man, the Howard's Word, and Lapah, AKA.
And travel with me if you dare, on a mission within the depths of your mind to be deprogrammed and enlightened. I am Tazadaq, aka the Deprogram Enlightener. And on this journey, you follow me down into the rabbit hole and you forget everything that you thought you knew because you're suffering from cognitive dissonance. Follow me now into the rabbit hole to be deprogrammed and enlightened. From relationships to working out to vegan diet to the law to the Bible, it's all here. Best channel on YouTube. Now come into this rabbit hole and be deprogrammed from everything that you thought you knew. That's how we own it. This is Yahweh's work. Yahweh's work, blessed and unstoppable. This is Tazadoctrine. This is Tazadoctrine. Hey yo, with the devil, this is Tazadoctrine. The stuff they don't want you to know. Shalom, 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 kom yasha Allah, kom yasha Allah, bokeh tov. Once again, you're now under the sounds of the voice of your brother, the Kahan Tazadaq, the general. And for the record, this is not legal advice. I do not offer legal advice. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a competent counsel, and then please be advised. Everything I'm about to give you is strictly for educational, informational, entertainment purposes only. First of all, giving all praises to the God of our forefathers, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, whose proper name is Yahweh. So I'm coming at you through the spirit of Yahweh, Bahasham, Hamashiach, Yahweh Shah. This is Tazadoctrine. This is Tazadoctrine. What is Tazadoctrine? Tazadoctrine is a process of being deprogrammed and then enlightened with right knowledge. You will be astounded by what you thought you knew. You will be astounded by what you thought you knew. So, if you come to this particular venue, you have to come with an open mind. Come with an open mind, or you will actually have difficulties maintaining and receiving the information. This is Yahweh's work. This is God's work. So, with that being said, I would like to talk to you about managing commerce as a secure party creditor. Tazadoq's Tazadoctrine. This is Yahweh's work. Now let me talk to you about how a creditor should survive. Now I want you to please take note that this live stream, information, I've been putting this information out for what, like 9-10 years. Left YouTube, came back. I'm not one of your Johnny come latelys. If you look on the internet, then you'll see that I've been here for a while. Now, I got a question. If you are indeed a secure party creditor, wouldn't you like to know how to properly operate as a secure party creditor instead of consistently putting yourself right back in the system with the use of a zip code, a social security number, and so on and so forth? And if you're not a secure party creditor, what are you waiting for? What are you waiting for to become a secure party creditor? Go to our website, www.truedisciplesofchrist.org, and become a secure party creditor now. What are you waiting for? And to all of you that may be undergoing a foreclosure process, I want to tell you this. My five sets of DVDs that was actually a webinar that I converted into DVDs are now available on the website, www.truedisciplesofchrist.org/shop. If you're undergoing foreclosure, before you pay thousands of dollars to a jackass bar attorney, you may want to check those out. It could save you thousands and save your house. This is not a scam. This is God's work. This is an effective process that if you apply it correctly, it will save your home. It's for educational purposes only. Again, I don't offer legal advice. So with that being said, get over to the website now. And by the way, as you enter the room, give this video a thumbs up. You see the donation link below. You could donate. Please show support to keep the deprogram enlightener going, aka the general of the true disciples of Christ. This is Yahweh's work. You see it. It's God's work. So now, getting to this, right? Forming commerce production side is something you need to get familiar with, right? I am an expert of how this works. A lot of people are experts. An expert is someone that's actually on the outside because they're external trying to figure out how things work. But with Tazadoctrine, I contend that I am an expert. I'm going to tell you how it operates from the inside out, right? And so while I may not agree with everything that a lot of these sovereign people put on the internet, I'm not a sovereign, I'm a secure party creditor. Nonetheless, some of the information is very relevant and so on and so forth regarding the commercial lien process, but none is relevant of what I'm about to give you through the set-apart spirit, the Ruach HaKadosh, right? That creditors use to discharge alleged debt. Now, I've actually produced, and I will show and prove in this live stream, you know, effective methods of actually discharging debt. So, as with everything else, being a secure party creditor, living as a secure party creditor, operating secured, or if you choose, living as a sovereign, as everything else, this is for educational purposes only and not to be taken as legal advice. Now, in public society, there are two sides to commerce. There's two sides to the commercial process. Most of you don't comprehend that. I get people that tell me they're secure party creditors all of the time, and they're contacting me to handle a simple commercial presentment. It means you wasn't taught right by whoever allegedly taught you, right? The only thing they really had you do was file a bunch of papers, and you're a secure party creditor pretender, right? So, nevertheless, in the public society, there are two sides to the commercial process. One is the production, which is actually private. That's the side I'm on. Or the supply side, if you will. The other is the consumption, which is the public side, right? Now, on the production side, goods and services are created by public society to be marketed to consumers. One of your first problems are too many of you are consumers and not producers. So I, as a flesh and blood man, and you as flesh and blood people, expend your energy for labor to create goods and services by working for these corporations registered in public society, right? And the flesh and blood people anticipate that they will be compensated for their energy of their labor by receiving the goods and services which they desire and are necessary for their life. Now, since the same company to which they expend their energy, the same company to which you expend your energy, Donald Gill, the same company to which you expend your energy. I'm talking to you right there that pretend you don't know who I'm talking to. Delette Walker, Shimshon, Israel, the same company to which you suspend your energy, good brother Ricky. By labor and production is not usually the same company from which people will secure their goods and services for consumption. The creating of a thing called money, right? This thing called money is used as a storage of commercial energy, which allows a more efficient distribution of consumer goods to the ultimate consumer. So by the secure party creditor or the sovereign living amongst a bankrupt society, there is a critical difference between the use of public money and the use of private money. You got to understand this. You got to understand this. This is why many of you, you accept that the values don't work. And some of you, you're YouTube whores. And what I mean by that, you channel hop. You go from here and here and here. You're listening to people all over and you get confused. Because no one's else doctrine on YouTube is like mine. This is strictly Tazadoctrine. This is right knowledge. This is the right way. I use this way because it works for me every time. So the use of public money has vested in it a use of tax on a benefit that is not right. Nevertheless, the use and consumption of goods and services from the industrial commercial revenue, right? They call it revenue. It's revenue. They're taking it out of one venue, putting it in another, without a discharge of the public bankruptcy liability connected with the goods and services constitutes a public use for which there is a tax penalty, also known as a lien, good brother Steve, or claim upon the strawman for said use. If you don't comprehend what I just said to you, you go back and you listen to this video no less than six times. And if you don't do it, you are going to miss something. Do you understand? So I'm trying to paint a mental diagram for the foreign commercial process of dealing with the public production side of the United States trust, the United States democratic economy. It does not deal with the consumption side. The picture that I'm trying to paint right now does not deal with the consumption side. This mental picture that I'm trying to create in your mind is actually painted to educate one as to how the public funds that carry a use penalty can be converted to private funds that do not carry a public use penalty. Do you understand? So the image, we're dealing with imagery right now. The image that I am trying to create in your mind as vividly as possible shows the Republic venue on the left side of the chart of your mind and the public revenue on the right side. So the public is the bifurcated Democrat bankrupt corporate government controlled by the creditors to the bankruptcy and ruled over by a military government operating under necessity and war powers. Stop me where I'm lying at. Now remember, the necessity is the mother of invention, whereas the Republic side is the private side of the nation. It deals in private property. The public side deals in public entrance, where the ownership of property is based on socialistic or communist ownership. The legal title to this property is channeled through the public side as a transmitting utility. The security entrance is held in the name of the state for the benefit of the state, even though there may have been a sale of a bond on the private market. However, since the state is bankrupt, the real owner of the so-called legal title or the private holders of the security entrance sold in the commercial marketplace by the United States Trust in order to secure credit financing to carry on the task of the government. The government and the state only have a use of the property until the creditor or creditors are repaid, the assets are redeemed. Now, if one wants to truly remain in the Republic after having secured title to one strawman, then one must not make a use of the public entrance. Do you follow me? Do you understand? So within the United States economy, you can't do that. The use is made when the title to the straw man is held in the same name of the state. Same name of the state. And not in one's own private right. When public funds are spent without first discharging them, pursuant to the resolution of Congress in 1933, House Joint Resolution 192, Public Law 73-1048, Statute 48, thereby making them private property. So the title to the straw man is held in a private right when the title is redeemed by a security filing on the private side of the register by way of a Uniform Commercial Code, UCC-1. This is all part of the secure party creditor process. Become a secure party creditor today. What are you waiting for? The filing will contain your birth certificate, which you will have redeemed by accepting and returning it for value with right of a charge back. The birth certificate, or prior to the redemption under a public registration by way of the corporate filing, or if there was no filing at all, by presumption. So once your strawman is reclaimed by becoming a secure party creditor, I've been telling you for years, become a secure party creditor. You fall for the okey-doke. You listen to the de facto. You fall back and you fall in trouble. What are you waiting for? Become a secure party creditor today. Visit the website, www.truedisciplesofchrist.org/shop. So once the strawman is reclaimed by the private UCC filing and the other secure party creditor process, then the commercial process shown that I painted in your mind that you should have actually be able to see vividly now can be exercised to discharge public funds with private funds for goods and services in a tax exempt and levy exempt mode that have been stripped of their public liability. This is what I was trying to tell you, my good brother Steve. Become a secure party creditor today. What are you waiting for? You want to make the alphabet soups go away? Become a secure party creditor. But if you want to remain sick, keep eating the alphabet soups jargon. Assumptions is how they operate, right? Let's us assume that the Republic, which is actually the private side, right, of the chart that I painted in your mind, good brother Steve, is where the substance of the world is located. It is in the land of reality and not fiction. It is called the Republic. It is also referred to as the state in legal literature. If the private property rights are practiced here, then non-negotiable instruments should be used instead of negotiable instrument. This is also the venue where retail sales of goods and merchandise is to be conveyed by purchase with private funds. Now, upon a sale of property by retail, the title to the goods and services should become private and not affect the public entrance. Do you follow me? This will require that a discharge of the public funds be made by private funds in the transactions in order to cancel the national debt of the said public funds and make the property tax and levy exempt. It will make them property tax and levy exempt. I'm good brother Steve, I hope you're listening. I hope you hear me, King. Now, let us assume that the public side of the chart that I painted in your mind is the corporate fiction known as the United States Trust, INC. It's a corporation. Go and check it out. 28 U.S.C. 3002, subsection 15A. Or other corporate democracy in order bifurcated nation, right? Now, it is known in many legal writings as this state instead of the state. So public funds pass as a money, but the user has no legal title in them except for naked possession. So none of these funds are redeemable for any substance within the public sector. Public legal instruments that pass as money are called negotiable instruments and can be passed from person to person by negotiation or endorsement. This commercial side deals in wholesale. Enter corporate sales. Only fictions exist on this side. You didn't hear me? Only fictions exist on this side. Look at my eyes in the camera. Only fictions exist on this side of the chart that I should have actually not painted in your mind. No real flesh and blood people inhabit this jurisdiction. One strawman is required to deal in this jurisdiction. One strawman is either a public corporate entity called an individual, if the birth certificate is registered publicly, or the strawman is a corporation sole if the birth certificate is registered privately under the secure party creditor filing. The strawman is identified by the all capital letters name or with an initial or with putting a first name before the last or putting Mr. or Mrs. in front of it. Do you understand? An abbreviation identifies the strawman. The strawman is neither good nor bad, though. It is a tool upon which commerce can be conducted in a military economy by registration, and this is what I'm doing. Now, since the national bankruptcy of 1909 AD, the United States has, by treaty, established the Private Federal Reserve Bank Act and corresponding creations of the Private Federal Reserve Bank System for the purpose of holding the public securities, the titles, to all assets owned by the United States or pledged to the United States of the United States as a collateral to the private creditors of the bankruptcy. What this means is that the Federal Reserve System straddles the bar separating the Republic side on the chart that I should have actually now painted in your mind from the public side, right? Now, the Secretary of Treasury is the public military officer in charge of the bankruptcy and would deal with the private external claims and the public internal claims. The Secretary of the Treasury deals with the internal banking system and the private internal revenue service, which is hired to investigate monies dedicated to public use and charges for said call, so-called taxes. So this makes the office of the Secretary of Treasury a corresponding bank for the private side to deal with the public side, if you could understand. Now, the bar, the damn jackass bar attorneys, bar judges and so on and so forth, that I try and paint in your mind, separates the Republic from the private. It separates the external venue from the internal re-venue. The bar can also be called a mirror. Everything in the public side appears backwards to what appears in the re-public side, right? This is why your civil and criminal cases go backwards to what you anticipate. The mirror prevents the internal re-venue from seeing the activities of the Republic. But it does not prevent the Republic from observing the activities of the re-venue. The attorneys and lawyers are the guardians of the bar. The attorney's duties are to atorn from which comes attorney, the public activities towards the public policies of the re-venue. Not law, but public policies of the re-venue when the properties involved in the commercial transactions have legal title by the public. Remember, your pledge by gift of the birth certificate is still to the state and the purchaser of the security sold by the state. The lawyer's duties are to resolve controversies between the republic or private non-republic rights, property where the title to the property is held in the republic side, and those rights of the public. So lawyers work on issues of law between parties of different jurisdiction or between panics, should I say, within the public and the private sectors. Attorneys work only on issues of public rights and policies within the bankruptcies where there are no private rights based upon the private title to the property. So we will assume that a flesh and blood man or a womb man who has legal title to his straw man by way of secure party creditor is legally and lawfully capable of conducting commerce within the revenue. Unfortunately, it's not that way. Because I got people that went to other people to become secure party creditors and you contact me all the damn time. Which means you should have never filed that damn paperwork until you learn properly. You don't know a damn thing. You understand? Learn. Open book. This is why I put books out, man. Go to the website, truedisciplesofchrist.org/shop, and get every one of my books because you don't know. You think you know, but you have no idea. So we would think that someone that's actually taken control of his straw man by becoming a secure party creditor is legally and lawfully capable of conducting commerce within the revenue or the public jurisdiction through the straw man who is privately registered by way of a secure party creditor. Do you understand? In one of the 50 public states. We will assume that if the straw man does not affect a public interest by way of a use, that such commercial intercourse will not take away any rights, titles, or interests of the straw man or the flesh and blood man who is conducting commerce or commercial intercourse by way of the straw man. So stop asking me, oh, can I still work? You don't understand this. All commercial instruments within the republic are non-negotiable. This means that they cannot be passed by mere endorsement or negotiation. They must be passed by way of an affidavit of assignment from party to party. Do you follow me? Do you understand? Do you understand? The affidavits must be affixed to the non-negotiable instrument to establish the private assignments of the parties. In essence, a UCC-3 release or partial release is a private registered notice of assignment of an interest in a non-negotiable instrument. So we will assume, right, that every man and woman has an unalienable right to labor in the society, and that such labor by a flesh and blood man will be permitted within the United States by way of the straw man as long as the straw man does not make a use of public funds. So in other words, the living flesh and blood man has unalienable right to labor only if the flesh and blood man owns legal title to the straw man. Do you understand? Do you understand me? So on the public side of commerce, within the democracy, the public side only deals with fictions. Therefore, it is not the flesh and blood man who works for the public corporations such as General Motors, such as Mercedes-Benz, such as BMW, such as IBM, such as Microsoft, such as Apple, but the straw man. You understand? So in other words, your corporation or your corporation soul works for the corporation. Your straw man is a transmitting utility to conduct goods and services into commercial pipeline from the public side to the private side and vice versa. The term transmit means what? What does it mean? It means to send or transfer from one person or place to another. The term utility in patent law means industrial value, the capability of being applied in practical affairs to prove advantages in the ordinary pursuit of life or add to the enjoyment of mankind. So a transmitting utility is the property which is used to send or transfer industrial value from one person to another or one place to another. Under the person-to-person, the transmitting utility sends goods and services from the industrial corporation to the flesh and blood man. Under the one place to another, the straw man or the transmitting utility sends goods and services from the public side to the private side of the national economy. Do you understand? Now, when it's hardwired to go to work for any person in the United States, it is the straw man who gets hired. The living flesh and blood person or man is the corporate official representing the straw man who signs the papers and contracts for the straw man. You got to be able to understand this. The name of the person who is hired by the public corporation is most likely the flesh and blood's Israelite, a Christian appellation spelled in all capital letters and having a middle initial that is in the first letter of the living flesh and blood's middle name, right? The social security number is the public account number assigned to the straw man when the living flesh and blood man registered the straw man for a commercial account with the Department of Health and Human Services. The services are what the straw man does for the public sector and not what the public sector does for the straw man. What the public sector does for the straw man is merely public benefits provided for the service of the straw man. So when we operate from the republic side of the government, we will not be using any of these public benefits available to the straw man. Now, considering what I just stated, right? We will now try to get you to understand an explanation of this mental picture that I'm painting in your mind, right? We assume that your straw man is working for the corporations such as Mercedes-Benz, Microsoft, Apple, General Motors. It does not make any difference what name the corporation carries, right? Even so-called private corporations are chartered by stale governments, which are all federal in nature, since the states have pledged their full faith and credit of the states to support the federal government in its bankruptcy. Therefore, a state charter to do business is a security held by the federal government. This can be actually appraised security, just like the birth certificate, which can actually be bought and sold in security markets. The buyer of the federal security holds the legal title to the corporation, making the private corporations the property of the United States and its creditors. Now, how does one get paid with private money? See, when the straw man works for Mercedes-Benz, Microsoft, Apple, General Motors, the straw man expects to be paid for the energy the flesh and blood man expends. The payment cannot be in public funds, though, without incurring a public liability. The straw man must ultimately be a transmitting utility to convey private funds to the flesh and blood man. So, Apple, Microsoft, General Motors, Mercedes-Benz is going to pay the straw man in public funds. This is all that General Motors or Microsoft has. This payment will most likely be by way of direct deposit, electronic funds transferred today in the straw man's bank account. The fund transfer will be arranged by agreement between Apple, Microsoft, General Motors, whatever corporation you're working for, and the straw man by contract at the time of the establishment of employment. An agreement to deposit the funds directly into the straw man's bank account will be signed by the straw man. Now, once the paycheck funds are directly deposited by Apple, Microsoft, General Motors, who the hell ever, Mercedes-Benz, into the straw man's bank account, at point B of this image that I'm painting in your mind, the straw man's bank account will notify the straw man of the deposit with a bank statement of some kind. The bank statement is an offer from the bank that the public funds have actually been deposited into the straw man's account for use. The offer constitutes a commercial solicitation into a contract for which the funds deposited into the bank are the consideration for value. there are only five possible responses to the offer. The five responses are actually designated as transverse, a demur, a mute response, silence, or no response, which is acquiescence, a protest, and acceptance. Now, for obvious reasons, to a learned student of law and commerce, the only logical response to banks' solicitation would be number five, acceptance. What is acceptance? So at position C of this image I painted in your mind, the straw man would do acceptance in return for value of the solicitation or offer set forth in the bank statement. This acceptance for value would include the acceptance for value of public funds contained in that account. We now have number one, offer. Number two, acceptance of the offer. Number three, value or consideration. This is all the elements necessary to make a firm contract between the parties. The acceptor of the contract is the holder in due course or the legal title holder of the property. The acceptor would notify the bank that the straw man's request that the order of the court be released to the straw man. The order of the court is in reality the documents of title of the true legal title to the property the bank has actually offered in solicitation, which, or the public funds. So if the true legal titles to the public funds in the bank account were turned over to the straw man, then there would be no public use of the funds left to the straw man. This would then mean that there would be no taxation upon those funds and no possibility of levy upon those funds by the public side. This is exactly what we want. This is exactly what you don't know how to do. This is exactly what you've been failing to do. This, in effect, washes the public use from the funds and turns the funds into a private right belonging to the straw man. But remember, this can only be done when the straw man is the private right of the flesh and blood man by becoming a secure party creditor. You can't do it as a debtor. Become a secure party creditor now. What are you waiting for? The problem is the bank does not have the capacity to turn over the goods or over the good legal title to the public funds. The bank is operating within bankruptcy on the public side and does not own anything by legal title. Therefore, the good legal title to the property will not be from over to the straw man upon the straw man's request that the order of the court be released to the straw man. This is a problem for the bank and not for you. The bank's solicitation by a firm offer was the bank's doing. So it must be presumed that the bank did it willingly and knowingly. Therefore, the straw man's acceptance and return for value constitutes the completion of the contract offer, acceptance, and consideration. And since the straw man is accepting the party and is the accepting party and not the offering party, the straw man is the holder in due course of the contract. The straw man has a legal title to the contract. The bank, the offerer, is the tail to the contract and must produce the property call out for delivery, in the contract. So the property is the title to the energy represented by the money shown in the account of the straw man with the bank. The bank has 72 hours. Remember, any kind of transaction of a security entrance, you have 72 hours, be it a traffic ticket or whatever. The bank has 72 hours to produce the property and titles requested in the acceptance. The 72 hours comes from the Federal Reserve Board regulations. 12 CFR part 226. Read it for yourself. 12 CFR part 226 involving rental sales by way of the Federal Truth and Lending Act. 15 USC 160. 15 USC 160. So when the transaction, which is a contract, is settled within the 72 hours, a condition of dishonor occurs, right? When it's not settled within 22 hours, a condition of dishonor occurs, right? So when the dishonor occurs, the straw man can do what is known as a banker's acceptance or a Bible Alpha BA to the dishonored agreement. How come you guys are not doing this? You send them notices, they don't respond. Why don't you do a banker's acceptance? Dishonored. The Uniform Commercial Code in Black Law's Dictionary defines the term banker to be, in general sense, person that engages in business or banking. In the narrow meaning, a private person who keeps a bank, one who's actually engaged in the business of banking without being incorporated, one who carries on the business of banking by receiving money on deposits without or with interest, by buying and selling bills of exchange, promissory notes, bonds, or stocks, or other security interests, and by loaning money without being incorporated. The term banker's acceptance means a draft accepted by a bank, usually for the purpose of a financing a sale of goods to or by a bank's customer. So a bill of exchange draft payable at maturity that is joined by a creditor against his or her debtor. Banker's acceptance are short-term credit instruments most commonly used by persons or firms engaged in international trade. They are comparable to short-term government securities, case in point, like a treasury bill, and may be sold on the open market at a discount. The term customer, as I use, in banking is any person having an account with a bank or for whom a bank has agreed to collect items and includes a bank carrying an account with the bank. So in those definitions that I just provided, a banker, right? Banker's acceptance and customer, the strongman becomes the person acting in the capacity as a banker. That is because the strongman is attempting to collect security underlying in the contract to which the strongman is the head or holder in due course. A banker has the capacity and authority to create a bill of exchange joined upon the debtor. The strongman creates the bill of exchange joined upon the bank as the debtor or one in dishonor to the strongman. The bill of exchange is payable to the strongman to compensate the strongman for the dishonor of the agreement. So the strongman has issued a bill of exchange to finance the bank's debt on the property belonging to the strongman that the bank possesses and will not give back. Therefore, the bank has bought it, and the bill of exchange is the financing instrument by which the bank is buying it. The contract is the underlying security or financial statement of the bank in possession of the strongman. So once the strongman writes the bill of exchange by way of the banker's acceptance against the bank, there are two tasks remaining for the strongman to accomplish. One is to seek the proper third party to accomplish the collections of the funds, and secondly, to discharge the public liability for the funds created by way of the bill of exchange. The strongman needs a collecting bank to deal with the bill of exchange. This is accomplished by the use of a secretary of treasury in the private side capacity. So at point D, in this image that I'm creating in your mind, the strongman has made a distum of the bill of exchange with the secretary of treasury into a private account. The bill of exchange is an asset. The bill of exchange is an asset to the strongman. It is like having a check made payable to the strongman that can be deposited, collected, and spent. The Secretary of Treasury becomes a correspondent bank to the banking of the strongman. A correspondent bank is a security firm, bank, or other financial organization which regulates or regularly performs services for another in a place or market to which others do not have the direct access. Security firms may have correspondents in foreign countries or exchanges of which they are not members. Bank, which serve as an agent for another bank in performing services. For example, carrying deposit balance or issuing letters of credit for banks in another city. So, knowing thus, The Secretary of Treasury is the correspondent bank to perform services and keep the account balances for the strawman as the transmitting utility. The Secretary of Treasury has a relationship with the bank in that they are both members of the Federal Reserve System and the strawman is not. The Secretary of Treasury has a fiduciary relationship and control over the bank and the strawman does not. The disputum made by the strawman to the Secretary of Treasury is made to the account to establish under the control of the Secretary of Treasury in its private side capacity. So this account is numbered with the same numbered attained by the registered mail label on the first letter of disputum made with the Secretary of Treasury. This number identifies the bank's account number maintained with the Secretary of Treasury. The private UTC contract, the entire secure party creditor packet, is your employer identification number. Some also use their SSN with dashes. Recognized by the United States Treasury as a so-called social security number of the strawman. But however, that social security number was created and granted to the strawman for the public side benefit or private side registration of commercial accounts. The public or the private use is up to the strawman dependent upon how the strawman's ownership is registered and used. The memory of account is the mirror image of the private UCC contract trust that appears on the public side of the account with the Secretary of Treasury. So when the disposition is made at point D, a mirror of funds also appear at the memory of the account. So in other words, if the bill of exchange was made out for a value of $10,000, then the depositor of the bill of exchange would create $10,000 amount in the private UCC contract account and a $10,000 amount in the memory account. Do you understand? Is everyone still with me? Have I lost anyone? If I lost you, you got to go back and listen to this 6 times. Maybe 10. Maybe more. Hopefully, everyone is getting it. Unfortunately, there's probably some that's not. And, you know, it is a necessity to understand this, to really, really be able to, you know, move effectively as a secure party creditor. Some will, some won't.
Depositum.
Now, again, the depositum, oh, we screwed that word up. A depositum of the bill of exchange would create a $10,000 amount again. So the definition of employer, right, in the United States Code is given in Title 26 U.S.C. 341. Salakia 3401 D1. Employer. For purposes of this chapter, the term employer means the person from whom an individual performs or perform any service, of which nature as employee of such persons expects that if the person for whom which the individual performs or perform the services does not have control of payment or wages for such services, the term employer, except for the purpose of subsection, means the person having control of the payment of such wages. When the strawman, brothers and sisters, accepts for value the offer from the bank of the public funds in the account of the strawman, then the strawman becomes the person having control of the payment of such wages. So This control of funds makes the straw man the head and not the tail, and makes the straw man the employer and not the employee. So the public side now becomes the servant of the straw man. The straw man becomes the employer. Since the straw man is actually in legal title control of the funds are now private. The straw man has the capacity to direct the Secretary of Treasury to release the private funds from the private private UCC contract trust account. So this should be becoming clear, hopefully. The funds can now be released by a money order that can be made by any non-negotiable draft, a company with a corresponding UCC partial release instrument registered with the Secretary of State where the UCC filing was made. Now the money loop is complete. Public funds were initially released to the corporations, was done with location A, from the Federal Reserve System to the finance public industrial commercial creation of goods and services. These public funds found their way from the Federal Reserve to the corporations into the strawman's bank account. From here, the funds were privatized by non-negotiable acceptance and chargeback and a non-negotiable bill of exchange, which was the basis of depositum with the Federal Reserve by way of the Secretary of Treasury. The funds were then released out of the private side of the Federal Reserve. There is a mirror event. The funds first were released out of the public side to the corporation and then out of the private side to the straw man owned by the flesh and blood man. The remaining task is to discharge the public funds with the private. How does one discharge the public side of the obligation? The depositum of the bill of exchange requires a collection. The bill of exchange is written on a bank, so the bank is liable for the amount of value placed on the bill of exchange. The bill of exchange has funds deposited into the strawman's account with the bank at point B on the mental chart I painted in mind. Since the strawman will not withdraw or use these public funds, they are available by the bank and the public side. Now, from the point of view of General Motors or Mercedes-Benz and so on and so forth, or whatever other corporation there is, the strawman is the employee. The wages that the strawman collects will be reported by General Motors to the Internal Revenue Service on a W-2 statement at the end of the year. Now, the Internal Revenue Services will be expecting the strawman to report these wages in public money or a lax tax, or a tax return, right? The strawman must file a tax return to report these monies, but what kind of return? Listen to this good brother Steve. Now, users and recipients of public debts create money, usually file a 3040 return, 1040 return, with the Internal Revenue Service. The tax liability associated with the return of income is based upon the use value of the property and the state had legal title to and the strawman had used up. Now, that the strawman is not making a public use of the public funds from Apple or Microsoft, there is still a requirement to report the funds and where they are in the public sector to help discharge the liability. The tax return form used for this purposes is the 1040 ES. The 1040 ES form goes to a different office than the 1040. There is no signature required under penalty of perjury on the 1040 ES. Did you know that? There is no signature required under penalty of perjury on the 1040 ES. I think I need to say that again. I didn't think you hear it. The 1040 ES forms reports the estimated public tax liability and pays the tax in quarterly installments, right? So let's say the strawman accepts value of funds in the bank at the point C, which I painted in your mind, in the amount of $50,000. The depositum of $50,000 appears at point D on both the private and public side of the account. The strawman then reports a $50,000 income to the Internal Revenue Services by way of a 1040 ES. The payment voucher is made out in the name of the strawman for $50,000. A draft is then made out to the Internal Revenue Service on January 2020, the United States Treasury allows the IRS to acquire the $50,000 of funds from memory account with the Secretary of Treasury. But remember, these funds only exist if someone collects these funds from the person made liable on the bill of exchange, which is the bank. The funds are available at point F, right? So the duty of the Internal Revenue Service is to collect the public funds for the Secretary of Treasury, for whom the IRS works. The corporations have accounts with the IRS. The bank has accounts with the IRS. When the straw man has tendered the drafts to the IRS to collect the public funds created with the bill of exchange with the bank as the payee, it is the duty of the IRS to make this collection. The collection attempt is shown mentally within your mind from what I've actually been feeding you. So let's call it point G. So once the IRS has actually collected the public side of this debt from the bank, let's say point H, the private side funds becomes available for use in the private sector, right? So it is now apparent that the IRS has collected the public funds from the bank, which basically represent public funds deposited in the straw man's account in the bank by Microsoft or Apple or General Motors or whoever. It is also apparent that the IRS has also acquired the mirror of the private funds from the memory of account with the Secretary of Treasury. Thus, this joining of the private and the public funds by the IRS is the discharge of a negative by a positive account pursuant to public policy expressed in House Joint Resolution 192 and Public Law 73-10-48, Statute 48. This cancels the public liability and extinguishes the public debt associated with the money acquired by the corporations from the Federal Reserve System. Do you understand, Steve? Do you understand? So this occurs at point I. So this collection of the public debt by discharge through the account of the private straw man helps the public sector by lowering the overall public debt. It is basically privatizing a public government economy. It also restores the flesh and blood man the rights of a laborer without public liability, which is the way that it should be. Do you understand? And so with that, I'm going to bring this to an end. Watch this video no less than 6 times. It is imperative that you study this, that you share it, that you learn it, and use it at your own risk. But it is effective if you could only stand it, if you could overstand it, understand it. Just don't stand under it until you're certain. This is Tazadoctrine. And I'm Tazadaq, the deprogramming enlightener, doing your Yahweh's work. This is your Yahweh's work, God's work. With that, I'm going to say Shalom. Again, the foreclosure DVDs are available on the website. Go to the website now, truedisciplesofchrist.org/shop, and order the DVDs and also become a secure party creditor. And if you think you have the ability to become a member of the True Disciples of Christ, to become a member of one of the True Disciples of Christ commandos, visit the website, click on the Join Us page, and maybe you could become a True Disciple of Christ. That's how we own it. Shalom.